Hello, I'm Swami. Giving a lecture in mythology. I'm a scientist. Preaching gospel, Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam. Full of real Islam, free of Sharia. This full of Sharia Islam is of Satan Al-Djmar Al-Aksa. The mullahs are the priests in the churches. They have no place in Christ Jesus. In Jesus, everyone has to give his own account to God. And these people are in the churches, the priest, the pope, and all that was created by the temple Jews, temple priests, who are good for no other job than job of a priest. So after the destruction of the temple and the death of the apostles, they overpowered the church by jumping over the wall and established themselves as today you can see their product. And they were killing more people than what the temple priest was doing. Matthew 12 verse 43 to 45 was fulfilled in them. And today they are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. And that is what you can see that Moses, because they became unfaithful, Abraham unfaithful to Yahweh, when the 11th crook patriarch, they wanted to kill Joseph, but sold him as a slave to the Egyptian. He was truthful and faithful to Abraham and Yahweh. The 11th crook who wanted to kill him, they were unfaithful to Abraham and unfaithful to Yahweh, so they were thrown out of the promised land. Kicked out, and they went to Egypt, a foreign land. Over there, the people respected them first, as they had done to Joseph. But soon they showed their colors of liars, murderers, and all that. And Jesus described in John 8, verse 44, that your forefathers are liars, murderers, and super basket fanatic devils, and they took stone to kill him. So when they came to their old habits, then the Egyptian, the faithful sons of Abraham, they made them slaves and made them suffer so much so that Moses had to appear to rescue them. Moses brought them faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh. When in the wilderness, he lifted their rift by making them faithful sons of Abraham, and no more fighting among them. And when they were united as the sons of Abraham, and then they were asked to go and occupy your land. And the land was lush green. So that was under Moses, because they repented 40 years in the wilderness called Sukkot. And today they make the Sukkot a festival. Well, you can see, if you are thrown out of your family home, and you will call it festival, that is their way of dealing with the religious knowledge. And today they are again brought back to the promised land after they had killed Jesus under King Pilate. They killed Jesus and they were thrown out of the promised land. As Jesus gave the last parable in the temple of a wine press. Wine press is the temple that made the moral laws, the old wine. As they were making old wine corrupted, adulterated. Genesis 17, the chapter of circumcision, is highly corrupted. Only the fools will believe it. So this circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. Nobody else can have it, except the people born of the seed of Isaac, sons of Isaac. I lived in Ghana. Over there, people have tribal mark on their faces. You can easily recognize this man belonged to this tribe and that tribe. And they live like brethren. If you give them something, they will all share. And that is what the quality of God is, that we all share and love each other. So, the chosen people under Moses, when they returned to their promised land, they found the promised land lush green, welcoming them into the promised land. And that is told by Christ Jesus in the parable of the prodigal son. Prodigal son is Isaac, elder son is Ishmael, and father is Abraham, to whom the promised land belongs. Today they were brought back. Remember, they killed Jesus and they were blasphemers. And today they are brought back into the promised land. Was promised land lush green as it was during the time of Moses? No way. Because today they are brought back for final burning through atomic war, which is expected soon after 14 November 2023, this month. Anytime, you know, after 14 will be atomic war. So, I have done some calculation, which I have put it in the description, you can watch it. Today, Matthew 13, verse 24-30 is getting fulfilled. And the tears are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. So you will see them, what they are doing today to the Palestinians, which are also unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, but they have more purity of the blood in Abraham than these white and black Jews of flesh, claiming to be the sons of Abraham. They are not sons of Abraham. Abraham was Semitic race. He was not an Aryan race or Negro race, but Semitic race. Curly hair. But these people don't have curly hair. Very little trace of the blood of Abraham. So today they are brought up back into Israel for final burning. And that is expected soon after 14 November 2023, when Israel is 75 years plus 6 months old. That is, the menorah has 7 candles, 6 of Yahweh, and the 7th and middle candle is of Elohim, Allah, Abraham, Shamash. Shamash means God. So this is the time of Christ, Jesus, and God. Everyone has to give his own account to God. So it is going to be the judgment of God and not of men. So let's see what happens. Our Father God blesses everyone in agape, unconditional divine love, because everyone has the same soul as I have. And we are brethren. We are not strangers. As the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person, he was son of God. In that capacity, the stranger was his brother, more than his kith and kin. So he looked after him on philanthropic basis. In God we have mercy and philanthropy. In Satan we have killing and no philanthropy. Money come first. Our Father God blesses you, and this is an end time, and it's up to you to preach gospel or to reject it.